Along with buildings, roads are one of the most important things you can map on OpenStreetMap. First, log into OpenStreetMap.org if you're not logged in already. Let's try to draw the road somewhere you're familiar with, maybe your neighborhood, near your work, or where you grew up. On the upper left, there's a search box where you can type an address, city, town, or other important place. You'll notice the edit button is grayed out. You have to zoom in pretty far before you can edit. You may not find a missing road immediately. Coverage is pretty good for some parts of the world, like the United States and Europe. Try going to a rural area or somewhere that's had a lot of new construction to find a missing road. Once you've found one, click Line at the top of the screen or the 2 on your keyboard to start tracing the road. Make sure to do it carefully and accurately. You may need to zoom in a little bit to get a better view. If the road crosses another, make sure to click on the road it crosses so they intersect. When you're finished, double-click at the end of the road. Now you'll need to tag it as a road and give it the right category. Click Road on the left side. This brings up the different types of roads. The road categories in OpenStreetMap are based on the British Highway System, so they may be unfamiliar to you. You can click the I button to learn more about each classification. The dropdown will tell you a little bit about each road type, and there's a link for more detailed information. The link goes to the OpenStreetMap wiki, which has all kinds of guidelines on when to use and when not to use a certain kind of road. Here's the page for residential, for example. In general, if the road is a small street in a residential area, it's residential. If it's a small road not in a residential area, it's called unclassified. Note that unclassified doesn't mean it doesn't have a type. If you just can't tell what kind of road it is, that's fine. Just scroll down and click Unknown Road. In this case, we're going to select Unclassified, because it's a small road outside of a residential area. Each road has different attributes as well, things like the name, is it one way or not, the speed limit, what's it made out of, and much more. If you know those, enter them, otherwise leave them blank. Depending on where you're mapping, the roads may look different. For example, a major road in East Africa may look different from a major road in the United States or in Europe. A primary road in rural areas may look different than a primary road in urban areas. You should check on the OpenStreetMap wiki, wiki.openstreetmap.org, to see if the place you're mapping has a road tagging guide or other mapping guidelines. East Africa, for example, has its own road tagging guide with photos. Specific countries may have their own tagging guidelines as well. If you're mapping with the Humanitarian OpenStreetMap team's Tasking Manager site, there are often instructions there, too. Roads are vital around the world for transportation, commerce, emergency response, and a lot more. They're one of the most important and fun things you can do to contribute to OpenStreetMap. So let's get mapping.